friends, how's it going? It's me, Betty Jean. Today we're gonna be doing another ranking video. You guys seem to really enjoy these, and a lot of you have been requesting me do it with my liquid lipsticks, and there is just no way that I'm going to be able to rank all of my liquid lipsticks in one video. That would take forever. That's not happening. It's not possible. But I will break it down by brands and things like that and just kind of see how that goes. Today we're gonna do Dose of Colors. I have a fair amount of Dose of Colors liquid lipsticks. I have 17 of them. I quite enjoy the formula, and I sat yesterday and took my time ranking them from least favorite to most favorite, basically, and I have my reasons why. I'm really excited to share them with you and just kind of chat about Dose of Colors because I think their liquid lipstick formula is amazing. If I don't love whatever your favorite Dose of Colors liquid lipstick is, don't get offended. I shouldn't have to disclaim anything like that, but we all just have different opinions. I don't hate any of these liquid lipsticks by any means, even the very bottom one. I don't hate it. It's just my least favorite. If I didn't like it anymore, I wouldn't own it. Is the bottom line. I want really quick for you guys in the comments to guess what you think my favorite Dose of Colors liquid lipstick is. I actually said it in a video recently what my favorite one is, so a lot of you might be able to guess it, but I'm just curious what you think it is. I don't know if I have anything really else left to say in this intro, so let's just get on to the video itself. So we're just gonna go over kind of the bottom seven first, so then we can break it up into five and five. So the very bottom one on my list is called Old Flame. This one's gonna be kind of obvious why it's my least favorite. I just don't really wear these kinds of colors. It's kind of a muted orange, and it's a pretty color in theory. I just don't wear these colors very often, so that's why it's at the bottom of my list. That's pretty much it. I don't have any animosity towards it, but I honestly don't know why I purchased this because this is not my kind of color I like to wear. Number 16 is the shade Mood. This one, out of all the formulas, this one is the only one that's kind of weird for me. This one gets kind of cakey throughout the day. I do like the color. It's not something I gravitate towards all the time. It's a pretty color. It's just the formula is kind of weird on this one. That's why it's so far towards the bottom. The formula was more like every other one in this range. I feel like it might have been higher up, but just because the formula is a little bit weird is why it's towards the bottom. But it's not so weird that I feel the need to throw it away. All I do is just wear a lip mask under it and don't plan to wear it for a long period of time. Number 15 is the shade Campfire, and this is a very similar reason to Old Flame. This just isn't my kind of color. It's a burnt orangey kind of color. I do prefer this one to Old Flame. That's why it's higher up. But it's still not one that I wear very often. I honestly can't think of a time that I wore it recently. It's probably just been sitting around for a while. I don't know why I bought that one either. Number 14 is the shade Berry Me, and it's a cute color. It's a really pretty berry. I just don't personally wear berries very often. It's not my go-to kind of shade. It's a pretty color. It's not my kind of color, you know? This next one is Merlot, and this one's really, really cute. It's such a bright pinky red color. It's so pretty. I just realized when I was ranking these that I don't really gravitate towards this shade. I don't know why that is. It's just obviously not what I reach for. That's the only reason it's down so far. I don't reach for it very often. Maybe I need to try to push myself to. This next one is called Extra Saucy, and this one's a really pretty red. It's kind of just like your basic classic true red. It's not too dark. It's not too bright. It's not too anything. It's just a really pretty basic red, but just like with the last shade, I just don't find myself wearing it very often. Reds are not usually my go-to. It's very rare when I wear a red. I don't even have anything against reds. I just don't wear them too often. Maybe it's just because of certain hair colors. I don't feel like it goes with it very well, but that's the only reason. And number 11, we have another red. This one is called Brick. This one's definitely more of a brown red. It's very grungy. It's very cool. I like this shade a lot. I just don't love it as much as my top 10, but I do like this one a lot. If I'm going to wear any of these that are on my arm right now, it's gonna be this one. It's just a really cool, grungy, brick red color. It literally is the color of brick. I remember wanting this shade so badly, and every time I would buy from Dose of Colors, I would check their site, and this one would be sold out, so I would never buy this one, and then eventually it was back in stock, so I got my hands on it. Don't love it as much as I thought I was going to love it. Thought I was gonna wear it all the freaking time, but needless to say, it's still a really pretty color. All right, we're on the top 10. Number 10 is going to be Chocolate Wasted. This is such a good brown liquid lipstick. It's so pretty. It's so comfortable. It wears really nicely. I love a good brown lipstick, especially in the fall. I just think it's one of the yummiest things you can wear. It's so flattering on pretty much everyone. I can't think of anyone a brown lipstick doesn't look good on. Number 9 is Los Angeles, and I actually really, really like this shade. When I first got it, I wore it all the time. I think it's such a flattering color. It's like kind of rosy, but also kind of orangey red. It's really, really unique. I don't feel like I have a shade quite like it, and I think it's very lovely. This next one is called Bear With Me, and I actually expected this one to be higher up on the list because I've worn this so many times, but just through my ranking process, it just kind of kept getting pushed down a little bit. But it's just a really pretty pinky nude. There's nothing too exciting about it, and it in and of itself, it's just a pinky nude color. It's not that special or innovative, but I've worn this a lot, so I really thought this was going to be higher on the list, but something's beat it out, but it's still a really pretty pinky nude color. This next one, I thought for sure was going to be in my top like 4. I don't know why it's number what, 7? It just got beat out by other things. I was really shocked because I've worn this one so many times as well. This is Stone by Dose of Colors. I've recommended this to so many people. I think it's such a pretty mauvey nude. It's so pretty. I used to wear this all the time. It was my number 1 for a while there. So freaking pretty. I almost want to say this is my second tube of it because I ran through a whole first one, and I do not do that often, run through a lipstick. That one I managed to do it. I could not believe that it was not in my top 5. It's wild to me. This next one I'm actually wearing on my lips right now. This one is called Warm and Fuzzy, and this is number 6. This one is also a pinky nude, but it's a little bit deeper. Like, it has more warmth to it, and it's just slightly deeper than the other two. I think it's really pretty. It flatters a lot of different looks. I think this would flatter a lot of different skin tones. I like that it has that warmth and that depth there. I think that's why I think it would compliment a lot of different people. And I just think it's really pretty, you know? Now we are on the top 5. These are my 5 favorite lipsticks from Dose of Colors. They're so freaking pretty. This first one is Mondays. And I'll be honest with you, I actually forgot I owned this one until I was doing this. But as soon as I remembered I had it, I was like, I know this has to be in my top 5. It's just such a pretty dark browny nude kind of color. It's not like a totally nude on me. It's definitely more of a brown kind of color. But it's so grungy and yummy and warm. I love wearing this in the fall specifically, but I would wear this anytime. It's so, so cozy looking. It's just such a pretty color. This next one I love so much. I think I got this summertime last year, and I can't believe I haven't worn it in a while because it's so pretty. This is Strawberry Pop. It's such a pretty pinky red, but it's a little bit different than like Merlot. Merlot is a lot more of a hot, hot, fiery, hot pink with red in it. This one's more of an actual like strawberry pinky red color. It's so cute. I love the way this looks on the lips. It's so springy, summery, and just so juicy and so cute. And I need to wear it soon because it's been a while since I've worn it. My number 3, this one I was surprised because I've only kind of discovered that I like this recently. When I first bought the shade, I didn't like it at all. I didn't think it looked right on me, but now it's like my perfect light nude ever. I think it's so cute. It's kind of that looks like concealer lips but not quite kind of look on me, and I think it's really, really pretty. This one is called Sand. It's the perfect pale nude for me. Out of all of my nude lipsticks that I want like a pale, pale nude, this one's my go-to for sure. I will say I don't like to wear this one full-on, like with the wand doing a full-on covering my lips the way you normally apply a lipstick. I like to just kind of dot it on and pat it out with my finger until I like the way it's blended. I like that look a little bit better with this lipstick, but either way, I love this color so much. I would wear it every day pretty much if I could. Number 2, I knew this was gonna be number 2. I just knew. This is Truffle from Dose of Colors. I've worn this so many times. I wanna say this is my second tube as well. For a while, this one and Stone were my go-tos. I had them on hand at all times. I could not get enough of Truffle and Stone. It's just such a good nude. I don't know how to explain it. It reminds me of just like, I don't know, like celebrity skin from Jeffree Star. I'm not gonna swatch them next to each other, so I could be wrong, but it's just like a really good beigey based nude. It's not too light, it's not too dark. It's just a good mid-toned brownie nude, and it's so cute. My number 1 favorite ever. This one is Cork by Dose of Colors. As soon as this one launched, I knew I had to have it. It is the prettiest warm grungy brown. I love it with my whole heart. I think it's so stunning. It flatters every grungy look ever. It's so good for fall, but I wear it year round. I want to say this is my second one of this too. I've gone through a couple Dose of Colors lipsticks. I really like this formula, but this is my range. I guess you can kind of see like what I prefer versus what I least prefer. I would have always thought that I preferred bold lips, but I guess I'm really a nude lip person. I don't know. It's an easy go-to with bold, bright looks. I do like a bold lip, but I guess not enough to make it my top. You know what I mean? Because like I said, I don't dislike any of these. I just don't wear them enough and love them enough to put them higher up on the list. But this is kind of where we're at. What do you think of my ranking? I think this range looks really pretty. I am missing a lot of lipsticks from Dose of Colors, but I'm no longer a completionist, so I'm not trying to collect them all. I think that's what I used to want to do, but now I don't really care to. I would love for them to come out with some more colors, actually. I don't think they've come out with any new liquid lipsticks in quite a long time. I don't know. I'll have to check out their site and see, because it's been a while since I bought one from them. Have you guys tried Dose of Colors formula? Which color is your favorite? Do you love any of the ones I talked about today? Do you love any of the ones that I have not talked about ever? Like, are there ones that I need to have in my life? I would love to know. What do you guys want me to chat about in my next ranking video? I could do another liquid lipstick brand. I have liquid glitter eyeshadows. I have a lot of different things. Like, I have a lot of those Stila glitter and glow shadows. I could always rank those. Let me know what you want to see, and I will happily get on that. If you enjoyed this ranking my Dose of Colors liquid lipsticks video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you're not already, please hop over to my Instagram. It's BeautBean. Follow me there. I post every single day, and don't forget to subscribe here before you leave. I post at least 5 days a week, but it's usually 6 or 7. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Okay, bye.